So today we will be discussing about the innovation which is helping us reduce the various hazards caused by plastics. And we are also about to discover the success story of an engineer who has turned to be a successful entrepreneur even. So I would like to introduce David Gogoi, who is the director of Zerand. Hello, David. Welcome to the live session.
Hi, okay. Hi, Devanjan.
Yeah.
Thank you for having me here. Yeah. Thanks to everyone who joined in to listen to us.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure. I'm very grateful that you found out a bit of time amidst your, the busy schedule you might be having.
No, it's not an issue. No issue. It's not an issue.
Yeah. So, David, welcome to the live session. And David Gogoi is also a civil engineer who has graduated from Assam Vijayan College and is the director of Zerand now. So to start with, David, I would like to ask you some questions. Like, so tell me, how did this Zerand start? How the idea came into mind and how it was practically implicated?
So it was basically a college project. It was our final year college project. So we were given a task to do something innovative and do something with waste plastic in the civil engineering domain. So we thought of doing it in the building material domains because we were very fascinated towards it. And since we, as you already told, that we come from a civil engineering domain, so it was easier for us to do something there. So we initially we did some basic trials with plastic and some other materials, binding materials along with plastic. So we found out that it was not doing any good to the product, and we were basically not successful in the product. So we did some other other trial and errors. So finally, after maybe 10th or 15th time of doing trial and errors, we finally found out a product. After mixing plastic, fly ash, cement, and some organic chemicals, we found out that it was quite worthy of a product, and it was quite marketable. Basically, it was quite marketable. So till then, we were not sure that we will be going towards mass producing it or maybe going in an industrial setup. So it required more from us, more market research from us, more economical point of view, more economical research from us. So we did another 2 months of research spent 2 months of more research into the R&D and in fact the market research into the economics aspect of the product. So we finally found out that the product was quite good. It was quite good, and it was aligning to the to the basic, I mean, the market requirements, what was required in the market, and the cost perspective and the other perspectives which were required were also aligning to what we were trying to target. So finally, we decided that yes, we can go for mass production, and something can be done out of it. Then we went out in the market to find out where we can mass produce it. So we went out in the whole Guwahati market to see where we can, if we can find some industry where we can produce the bricks. Then we found out that a factory was closed. At that point of time, it was closed for around 1.5 years. So we found out that the factory, the geographical location of the factory and other aspects were totally aligning to what we were wanting to do at that point of time. So we thought that we can do something with that factory, but given the fact that we were very young at that point of time, not young actually, we were very unknown to every circumstances. So we were still in our college days. We were still in our final year. So we went and asked the landowner, who was the landowner. We asked them, if we can take the factory on lease, and if you would be willing to give us the factory. So obviously, seeing very young people and seeing that we have no market and we don't have any experience in the market, so he was also very reluctant to give his factory. So but it was something was there, so we found out our way to convince him. He was not at all convinced in the very beginning, but we found out our way. We convinced him. We got some money from our friends and families. We got some money from our college alumni. We took the factory on lease. Now for mass producing the bricks, we needed some good amount of money. I mean, 20-30 lakhs of rupees was required. So again, we went out in the market. We went to every banking institution or any financial institution which was there in in Guwahati. So we went everywhere, but everyone gave us a no, because I don't blame anyone. If I would have been on the on their side, they would have also said no to me, because it's simple mathematics, it's simple economics. So we don't have anything about them. But finally, we didn't give up. Actually, it was more than 2 months. Now, at that point of time, we passed out of our college. So at that point of time, we passed out of the college, and it was around 2 months when we were struggling to get funds or struggling to even do something. But we were very stubborn with our own idea and with our own vision. So we didn't give up, and we finally found out two very kind gentlemen who were actually alumni of our college, AEC. So they were really convinced with the idea, and basically they were really convinced with the people, with the three founders. We had three founders, so they were really convinced with the three founders and the vision that we share. So it was quite aligning to the vision that they were also sharing. So they immediately said yes to the project, and they said that yeah, they will be investing certain amount of money, and with that money we started the production. And since then we have been doing the production. In the very beginning, we started with just 250 bricks on a daily basis, and now we are doing around 2,300 bricks on a daily basis. So it is around 86% of month-on-month growth. So I find it very fascinating and very I find it very means
inspiring.
This kind of I'm quite happy that we have been able to reach such a point of I won't say success, but we are into the stepping stones of maybe success. I don't know what is going to be. So it's been a journey of almost 2 years now. Got our company registered in September, almost 2 years now. And there were many hiccups and many thorns in the journey. So, but we are very stubborn in our journey, and till now we are very stubborn, and we know we'll be very stubborn in our journey.
I have seen you like while growing, when you were in the struggling phase, and now you were settling up your business quite a bit. So here I will just ask you one more question. There is how do you plan to make it financially viable for you, or in the aspect of your customers expect, how do you think to make it financially viable?
So it is basically the our sales pitch. So the our sales pitch, it goes like this, that if you use our brick, the very first sentence that we use is, if you use our brick, you will be saving around 10-15% of construction cost in comparison to the normal red bricks. So ultimately the initial sale pitch really sells to our customers. So how it is economically viable to our customers? So it is like that. the if you use our bricks are bigger in size. It is equivalent to 6 red bricks in size. So if you use our bricks, we are selling at 45 rupees, 40 rupees X factory here in Guwahati. So cost of one brick is around 9 rupees. So 9 into 6 is around 54 rupees. We are selling at, let's say, 45 rupees landing cost, including GST and all. So still we are saving around 10 to 15% there. Then the joints are very less. So where they're also we are saving a lot of customers money. So basically, ultimately, it comes out to be 10 to 15% of less construction costs in comparison to the normal red bricks. So that really sells. That really sells because we are targeting the mass market. We are not targeting the class market. There are two basically markets, the class market and the mass market. So we are basically targeting the mass market. So in the mass market, price is basically one of the most important important thing. So so there the product sells, and plus when you say how we are economically viable to us, so how we are economically viable to us is that we have found out various materials which are actually waste products. Like plastic is one of the waste product, that is one of our raw materials. Then fly ash is also one of the one of our raw materials which we use in a huge amount. Around 60% is fly ash. So fly ash we have tied up with NTPC, the National Thermal Power Corporation. So NTPC has a program that the innovative projects, whichever are the innovative projects, so they give away the flyers for free. They give away the flyers for free of cost. So we are one of the innovative projects that fall into those category. So they are giving us the flyers at free of cost. So that really helps us in saving a lot of money in the production. Then of course we are doing some more research. We are using cement, which is of course very expensive. So we are still doing some research so that we can bring down the cost of cement substantially, so that our production cost comes down more, so that our selling price also comes down less, and we can give more value to our customers, so that we can bring more customers in our portfolio.
Okay, so here I will take one more one question from our my followers. So it's from Swarnab. So how much amount of plastic it takes to make a single block?
So a single block is around 7.5 to 8 kgs. So we use around 10% of plastic. So around 800 grams of plastic is used in a single unit. That is, if you compare that, if you see that economics, then it seems to be very small. But if you go for the mass economics, then you find out the total value of what we are doing. Because on a daily basis, we are recycling around 80 to 100 kgs of plastic. That is from a single manufacturing unit. We have currently two manufacturing units here in Assam, and we are having the third manufacturing unit at Chhattisgarh in the next year. So let's hope for the best. So yes. So
I hope that
in a single. Yes, thanks. So in a single unit, we are using around 80 to 100 kgs of waste plastic on a daily basis. So if you say the plastics are very lightweight, the density is very less. That is basic science. So the density is very less, but the thing is that the volume is very high. So when you compare the density with the volume, so around 80 to 100 kgs, so the density is huge. It will be covering a whole banquet hall. if I put it in a horizontal surface, so it will be covering a whole big banquet hall. So in terms of those aspects, so yes, we can say that the numbers are good and very attractive to the eyes. Yes.
So the most important question for you who came up from a very middle class family, you know, how did you manage to not select a conventional job and start something of your own and start as this innovation is great. I know, you know, like, but it needs a great courage, and you need to manage your parents and deal with them. So how did you do all these stuff?
So yeah, that's a good question, and many of our generation people really ask me this question, and maybe some elder people also ask me this question. So it was in our case we kept it very simple actually. So in the very beginning, as I already told that in the very beginning, two three months after when we passed out from college, we were struggling to meet our ends. I remember some day when I didn't have 20 rupees to buy rice for myself. The raw rice for myself. So I really remember those days when that day I cried a lot. I was alone in my home. You have to do something. You don't have to involve your parents actually. So my point of view is that you don't have to involve people. You have to, if you are struggling, you have to struggle by your own. Don't involve people. Don't say how tough your life is. How are you struggling daily? How it's getting very tough to meet all then? When you share all these things with your parents, they are very very soft people. Obviously, you are their own kid, and they would be wanting you to have a very 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 easy life. That's why they want us to get into jobs and all. So they don't want that we struggle a simple bit. So my basic funda was that I won't tell anything to my parents. Whatever struggle I'm doing today, I will keep it by myself. Maybe that's where I mean the partners come into the picture. I think the most important thing, a very successful entrepreneur will always say this thing to you. A very very successful businessman will always say to you this, that the more than your life partner, the business partner should be most more important to you. If you are into the business, your business partner should be more important, and you should be very very choosy in choosing your business partner more than your life partner. Now I was very privileged to have each other's hands. So because I remember when it was very very tough to meet our ends during those days when we are starting up. So we used to support each other when one was really dejected. One day you will be dejected and you will be feeling very low, then the other two people will somehow be consoling you and will be telling something that these things, just keep patience. And when I was very low and I was very dejected, so my partners would tell me that these two shall pass, as we say, these two shall pass, and just keep on doing your thing. Because and one more thing is very important, consistency and perseverance. I mean, more than hard work, more than smart work, the most important thing is consistency. You cannot do something if you are doing it maybe 3 days a week or 4 days a week. You have to do it 7 days a week. And there are no other options. There are basically no simple, no other options. You have to do things basically 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, maybe not 24 hours, maybe 15, 16 hours a day. So, but 7 days a week is very important. There should not be any Sundays or Saturdays for the entrepreneurs. I don't say for the people who are into the job sector, I won't say anything to them. But as an entrepreneur, I would say this, that there should not be Saturdays or Sundays in your life. So that really keeps you motivating. But when you ask me how you convince your parents, you cannot convince your parents. Basically, you cannot say something that will be convincing to them. They won't be convinced. What you have to do is that you have to just do your work. And when the things come to you, like when you were having some good savings, maybe you are having a good amount of FD in your account, maybe you are having a car, maybe you are having your own house, then they automatically get convinced. You don't have to say anything. It's with time. Just you have to give them the confidence that everything will happen. Just give me some time, and don't to someone who is listening to me or to anyone who is wanting to start up. So just don't share your struggles. Don't share your daily hustles to your parents, because they can't handle it. Your partners can handle it because they are on the same page as yours. But don't share your struggles and don't share your hustles to your parents. They can't handle it. So that is my basic theory. Yes, basic funda is like that. Okay.
So I have known you from the college days. You know. So yes. Zarin was not the first venture you started with. You started with very small things, and finally grew up to this big man.
Yes.
How was this journey of entrepreneurship has been to you? Like, how has it treated you? Like, was it a good experience till now, or how did you feel it?
No, it's a brilliant experience. Actually, I love to hustle. Actually, so the people who are starting up and who are really doing it very passionately and who really wants to be in the thick of things and wants to build something, if you ask them, everyone will agree with me. They will always say that they love their journey, because in the morning, I'm saying you from my heart, really. I'm saying this from my heart. In the morning when I wake up, I never wake up sad. I never wake up depressed that I have to go to the same or shitty office or like that. I'm always very very energetic and very very happy that today I'll be going to my office and today I'll be meeting this person. I'll be meeting always every day we have 5-6 meetings every day. We have 5-6 today also I had around 4-5 meetings. So when I see my notebook that tomorrow that today I have these meetings and I have to meet these people, so I really get excited. I really want to my basic behavior is my normal behavior is like I love talking to people. I love getting experience from people. I love sharing my own story to people. I love talking with them. I love getting knowledge with people. So whenever I meet maybe 4-5 days, 4-5 people daily, so I'm at least learning 4-5 new words from them. At least 4-5 new words from them, which are really helping me too. There, it's really helping me to grow as an entrepreneur, because basically whom we meet is basically the builders and the other big contractors. So they have done what we are wishing to do maybe 3-4 years from now. So they have already achieved it. So I really get to know what are the mentalities, what are their mentalities, and how they think. So I remember I just met someone the other day, and he's a very successful person. He drives a Mercedes, and he'll be driving another BMW in a couple of days. So he's a very successful person. So I was asking I was giving him a case study. It is basically my case study that I need certain amount of fund, and I'm stuck here and I'm stuck there, and I'm doing this and I'm really stuck here. So if you are in my position, then what will you do? Because he has already done it. Because already he has done it. What we are willing to do maybe 4-5 years from now, he has already done it. So I asked him, why, if you are in my situation, then what will you do? So he gave me some of his views, which are really helpful to me. Two, three opinions that he shared with me was really helpful to me, because I really liked, because those things were not coming into my mind. When I was approaching towards the problem, I was not approaching in that mindset. So he gave me 2-3 ideas which are relatively new to me, which did not stuck to my mind. So that's where the experience comes into the picture. So that's where the experience comes. That's where the expert advice actually comes into the picture. So that is really helpful. So I So that is basically this is my funda, that I wake up very energetic every day, and I'm actually very happy to go to my office every day. I really love meeting people, and I really love my my job. Actually, I really love my job. Yes, that's it.
Yeah, it's your success right now speaks of your hard work.
No, not. We're still winners, as I already said. Yeah, we are not successful.
There is a way ahead, but I wish you success, and you will be successful one day. Okay, thanks. So how does the currently, you know, like there are red bricks, there are AAC blocks. So how does Zedon brick stand apart, and how is the quality much better than those? Can we explain?
Okay. So when you say in comparison of with AAC with red bricks, so the basic point that we target in bringing our clients from red brick to us is that we say that as I already told you, we are 10 to 15 times cheaper than the normal red bricks. So there we are already having a plus big point. Plus point. Yes, already having a big plus point. Then the second perspective where we target our customer is that our weight is very less. First of all, we fall into the lightweight bricks category. Then the water absorption is also very less. These are two, three points are there, which really attracts the customer. In terms of AAC blocks, yes, AAC also falls into the lightweight bricks category, so they, you can say that they are one of our competitors. Yes, they are one of our competitors, but where we have the upper hand is that our strength is more than them. Our basic strength is more than them. Our density is a bit higher than them, so the strength is more than them. Then the water absorption is very less, so they have a water absorption of around 40%. 40% water absorption is there, and we have water absorption of only around 10 to 15%. So that is one of the big plus points to have, because in a place like Assam or anywhere in India, so if the water absorption is very high, so what happens is that the bricks tend to soak in water during the rainy season, and when the hot summer days comes, it tries to the water tries to evaporate from the product.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
In doing so, what the water does is that it creates a path. So in creating a path, it creates cracks in the product.
Yeah.
So there we are having the win game there. So we have very less complaints about cracks. So in fact, almost none complaints about cracks. But AAC has a lot of problems with cracks. So there we have the plus point. Yes, that's how we are competing with our competitors. Yes.
Okay. So lastly, I would like to ask, what would be your suggestions to the aspiring entrepreneurs who have so many ideas in their mind? Because whenever, India is a young country, you know, so there are so many ideas popping out in everyone's mind. So what would be your suggestion to them?
So to whoever is aspiring to be an entrepreneur, so there are some pros and cons here in entrepreneurship. First of all, the basic con that you have to tackle is that it's very hard. Actually, it's not easy. Entrepreneurship is not very easy. So the basic thing that requires that I found out in the last 2 years, I found out the most important thing that is required in an entrepreneur is thick skin. I say it in a single word is thick skin. Mota chamra. What I say ki entrepreneur or a businessman ko ek bahut mota chamra rehna chahiye. Now the thick skin is one of the most important thing that an entrepreneur should have. From any point of view, from personal point of view, you'll be struggling a lot. Your finances will be very poor. You don't feel like seeing your bank accounts and all. So there you should be having a thick skin. Then your parents will be not supporting, your relatives won't be supporting. They will be saying, joking about you on your back. So there you require having a thick skin. then in terms of going into the market, so the market is very harsh. The customers are not good. Actually, the customers are not good. Out of 10 customers, only one or two will be there, which will be good. They won't be willing to do something harm to you. But most of the customers are not good. Just see yourself, if you yourself as a customer, how you have treated another company. So you know how the customer's mindset is here in India. Everyone wants it in the cheapest price, and everyone wants the best thing in the cheapest price. So the customer's mentality here in India is very poor, very poor. So there you should have a very thick skin in terms of going into the market. If someone wants to be an entrepreneur, so just in one word, you should have a very thick skin. A small bullet should not come and attack you. So a small needle or a small bullet should not come and attack you. So you should have a very thick skin. And two, three other points, as I already told you, the consistency and perseverance. So these are the three, four points that really helps.
Okay, David, thanks for joining us. I will wind this interview here. I think we have answered many of the questions. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks, David, again to join us.
Okay, thanks. It was a privilege to be invited by you and to share something, share my journey and share my story to whoever is listening to me. So thank you for inviting me, and best of luck for your vlogs and for your journey, for your YouTube channel. Hey. So best of luck. Yes. Thanks
a lot.
Yes.
Thanks a lot, everyone.
Bye.